Welcome to Tantrum House Studio D. I'm Kevin Delp.
And I'm Melissa Delp.
Today we're looking at Robin Hood and the Merry Men from Final Frontier Games. Robin Hood and the Merry Men from Final Frontier Games is a 2-4 player semi-co-op competitive game that is worker placement with a little bit of dice rolling and is coming to Kickstarter at the end of February.
Now you're playing as one of the famous heroes like Robin Hood or Little John, and you're trying to protect Nottingham from the evil Prince John and the sheriff. But ultimately, there can only be one main protector.
Let's look at the prototype components. There's the game board, player boards, cards, tokens, meeples, bags, and dice. And here's some graphics of what the produced components might look like.
The game is played over the course of 5 rounds, and each round has 2 phases, the Merry Man phase and the Hero phase. During the Merry Man phase, players take turns playing a Merry Man card and placing out a Merry Man in one of the 8 areas on the board. To place in the main area of a gathering site, you can play any card and take one of the items shown.
To place a Merry Man in a hideout, your card has to match that icon and you get an extra benefit, like getting 2 resources instead of 1. You also have to have specific cards to build traps and barricades or send a Merry Man as an envoy to King Richard on his crusade.
Building traps and barricades will unlock rewards, like getting more resources or another Merry Man. They're also worth points at the end of the game, based on your level of reputation.
After everyone has played their Merry Men, you move to the Hero phase. At the beginning, you collect weapons dice by drafting 2 of them in a snake draft.
Then each player takes 1 turn. First, you draw a sheriff card and bad stuff happens, like adding soldiers, moving the sheriff, and activating a road.
Then you get to make 2 moves with your hero. You can go to any place that has a Robin Hood hat icon. The star shows the places where the sheriff can move to. Your hero can rob carriages, fight off soldiers, or even participate in a tournament. All of those require you to roll dice. After each player has taken a turn, drawing a sheriff card and playing their hero, the round ends and you perform some upkeep like retrieving your hero and Merry Men.
Even though each player is trying to win by scoring the most points, if you don't work together, you could all lose. That happens if all the pennies from a road are gone, or if one of the gathering sites is filled with guards at the beginning of a Merry Man phase. Building barricades and traps will slow both of those down.
So those were some of the basics. We didn't go into the major nitty-gritty of the game because we did a playthrough video of Robin Hood and the Merry Men on our YouTube channel, and we'd love for you to check that out and sort of see the flow of the game.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of decisions to make in this game, especially how to effectively use those Merry Men and your hero. But overall, the flow of the game is pretty easy to grasp. You're placing your Merry Men, you're drafting some dice, then you're resolving a sheriff card, and then you get to make some moves with your hero.
Yeah, the game is thematic. You feel like you're stopping those carriages with barricades, trying to rob the rich to get some loot, and you're trying to go on those tournaments. But you have to be careful, because if you push your luck too far, you could get caught and go to prison.
Right. This game is a bit of a hybrid. It has some of those Euro elements like worker placement and collecting victory points, but then there's also the luck and chance-based dice rolling. So unlike a game like Kingsburg or Rise to Nobility, where you roll your dice first and then choose your actions, in this game, your dice rolls are determining the success of your actions.
Yeah, but those rolls aren't completely out of your control.
True. You can give yourself better chances by rolling more dice instead of fewer dice, and you can spend distraction tokens during the hero phase to re-roll.
The art from the Miko is outstanding. I like the use of color in the game. Lots of vibrant greens and browns that make it feel forestry. And most of the icons are helpful and easy to distinguish.
We were able to play the game at several different player counts. And we had at least one where we all lost. Thank you, Kevin. But we also had some games where we played it completely and there was a winner. Also, Kevin. I would say the difficulty level does scale well at the different player counts.
Yeah, there are fewer pennies and hideouts with the 2-player, but I think it might be a little easier to work together.
Right. When you're playing four player, there's a lot of bad stuff that's happening during that hero phase. And you also have three other people that you're trying to outscore. So there might not be as much altruism going on. But the game does give you some incentives to help out, because some of those King Richard task cards, they actually want you to have pennies on certain roads or to not have guards in certain sites. So there can be instances where you're not only helping out everybody, but you're also helping yourself.
Yeah, so if you enjoy worker placement games and are okay with a little chance and the dice rolling, then check out Robin Hood and the Merry Men, coming to Kickstarter February 21st.